afternoon. Happy Wednesday. Thanks for joining us on Midday at 12:30. I am Amber Freeman, and we are going to get right to it today.
Right to it.
Right to it. You can't see who my pseudo co-host is, but I promise you, you know him. We're going to talk about the stresses of a packed holiday calendar, the pressures of spending money we don't have. That can all leave us financially strapped as well as emotionally and physically exhausted. Just saying all of that is exhausting. So thankfully, we have licensed pastoral counselor Dr. James Stillwell with us today to talk about how to get through all of this, get through December, through the beginning of January with our bank accounts, our emotional lives, and our bodies all intact and thriving. Thank you so much for being here.
My pleasure.
I would gladly have you as a co-host. It's kind of weird to start the show out this way.
Well, we can talk.
Well, you know, the price is high, right?
Yeah, right.
We'll do some bargaining. Well, thank you for being here. We do appreciate it. December is such a stressful month for a lot of people because it's all the highs.
Expectations.
Yeah, and then there's those lows that just kind of seem to go along with it.
Well, you're going to have a low following a high in your life no matter what.
What?
And so you got to plan for it and plan for rest. Plan for, you know, I love to take my calendar, just put X marks and say, I can't do this. I've got something on my calendar. It's an X mark.
Oh, I thought you meant to X through the days that you made it through. I was like, yeah, me too.
Those well, are there you fives. Go too. Draw you a little high five, draw you a little smiley face. So, give yourself a pat on the back.
Well, and you always stress, I think, no matter what we're talking about, the need to plan ahead. Is that even more important during
of
this
course.
Time?
Because if you don't take control of your schedule before the world does, they will.
That's true.
So go ahead and be proactive. I know we're just 2 weeks from Christmas and 3 weeks from New Year's, but there's still some time.
Oh, there's time.
And take whatever time you have.
Well, let's break down the different things that we're talking about. We talked about buying gifts, spending money. So many times we want to buy those items and we just really don't have the money, but we do it anyways.
We do it anyway, and that's not necessary. We can renegotiate that in many, many ways. And so part of that is gifts. When you have a trip and you're going to be traveling long distances, why go to the trouble of shopping and packing and all of that when sometimes a gift card is just as good?
So it's okay to do that.
Put a bunch of gift cards in your pocket and, you know, you don't have to travel heavy. You can travel light.
Well, and that leads right into kind of the whole emotional thing because just think about a gift card. So many of us have been taught the stigma of getting a gift card. It's not personalized. It's
well,
not
personalize
this, it's not
it to the point of getting what's appropriate for that person. Obviously, if you get a generic Walmart or, you know, Target gift card for everybody, you haven't thought about it.
But if you
know somebody really likes that, then that's appropriate.
Well, okay, so that's just one item on the emotional spectrum that we have to worry about. Mm-hmm. Out of a zillion other things, how do we handle that?
Well, the emotional stuff, part of that is you know what you need. And so not only take care of yourself on the calendar, but take care of yourself in communicating with people what you need and to do it ahead of time. You know, if you show up the day of an event and you said, well, that's not going to work for me, obviously you're putting them in a bad place.
Sure.
But you know 2 weeks ahead of time that you need a change, an alteration in plans. You need more time for yourself and less time for the event. Let them know as soon as you know.
Okay.
So and be clear, be honest, be respectful, speak for yourself. Here's what I'm going to need. You may have experienced a death or a breakup in your relationship or whatever where you're going to need to take care of yourself more. We'll just be more honest about that and tell them up front, here's what I'm going to be doing.
Sure. And that leads into, you know, emotionally we're tired, but a lot of times all of this leads to us being physically tired as well.
Yes, physically. So physically, I just went to my doctor yesterday for a follow-up. So I'm just reminded there's some things you need to do less, some things you need to do more. So what do we all need to do more? We probably need more sleep.
Yes.
Go ahead and schedule that.
Oh.
We probably need more exercise. Go ahead and plan on parking farther away and taking the stairs instead of the elevator. We need to eat less and drink less alcohol.
Which you know, hard during
those
this time
are just
of year.
Choices. Don't do it where you can say, I'm not going to have any pie. Say, I'll have a bite.
So
you know,
just kind of plan ahead.
Yeah, plan ahead. That's the factor on all of this.
Two of your best, biggest words. Dr. Stillwell, if we need help, how do we get a hold of you?
DrJamesStillwell.com is a great place to start. It's got all my contact information.
Fabulous. Definitely contact this guy. He can help you get everything in order. We appreciate you being here.
Good to be
so
with you.
Very much. Stay with us. We have more Midday Kentucky after the break.